Hello, everyone. Once again, CBOA, the Connecticut Bowling Operators Association, brings you another Duck Pin Challenge. We're here in Willimantic, Connecticut at the Lucky Strike Lanes. And my color commentaries are Craig Self, right next to me on the right, and on the end, Dick Bisson, the president of the Connecticut Bowling Operators Association. We'll have all of the bowling action for you after we return in a moment. What do we have for you with the top three bowlers today? The Senior Duck Pin Challenge Tournament Finals, and it's a handicapped event.
Norm, our first bowler today, top seed, is Bill Crudo. He'll be bowling in the second match today. And the first match features Pat Lopardo from Torrington and Mr. B.B. Messina from Waterbury. B.B.'s 76 years old and still averaging in the 130s. Pat Lopardo, a lot younger, 66, also averaging in the 30s.
Barely a senior.
Gives himself an opportunity to make a spectacular spare right off the bat.
Almost did it.
Pat Lopardo and his brother Danny, Arcade Lanes in Torrington, Connecticut. B.B. Messina, born in Sicily, Italy, 76 years ago.
Retired from 14 years from the American Metal Hose Company. Attended school in Waterbury.
Took smooth delivery for the first ball.
BB's son, Charlie, is a detective and a sergeant on the Waterbury force.
In qualifying for this event, he shot scores of 130, 150, and 150. Qualifying, incidentally, was held at the Cheshire Lanes in Cheshire. If I'm not mistaken, I think there were 286 entries.
They were from all over the state of Connecticut.
Qualifying scores right there, 151, 133, 151, plus a 42. Pin handicap. Based on a 131 average. He was a pin boy at the age of 16. He was a pin boy for 4 years at the Worcester Alleys.
Almost made that. So they start off with no marks, but we'll see a few before this is over.
In his spare time, he loves fly fishing on the Farmington River, which he's been doing since 1934. Here's Pat Lopardo, the Arcade Lanes in Torrington, where he loves to bowl. Here's his qualifying scores.
Right. If you missed those, Pat had 177, 128, and 137 for a 442 scratch, which is some shooting.
By having the five come out behind the one pin, then it made it a little bit easier to convert the spare. Not much, but a little bit.
There's a three-step delivery, and there's a pin bowler.
So at the moment, Pat LaParta enjoys a one-pin lead over Beebe. Beebe has a two-pin handicap. So while Pat has a one-pin lead right now after two frames, Beebe actually leads because he has two pins added to his 19, give him 21. Now the seniors qualifying tournament was open to men and women and took place over a five-day period at the Cheshire Lanes. They had contingents from the Bridgeport Stratford area, Torrington area, Waterbury area, the New London Willimantic area, Manchester, Hartford area, Newington. Maybe he's not used to this ball return.
His concentration was broken as the ball
still delivered
at
1-2 pocket.
Well, speaking to Beebe before we started today, and he was telling me how he actually likes bowling at Lucky Strike Lanes. And looking back through some of his accomplishments, I can see why. He won the Lucky Strike Eastern Classic back in 1966.
That's when the Lucky Strike was still in the center of Willimantic. We're on the road now going up toward Yukon.
Right.
However, the lanes
are
the same lanes. They brought them up here. This is a new building.
Beebe Messina's high single game, 237, high three game set, 528. Almost.
All right, we should have our first spare right here. Got over the jitters first three frames.
His most satisfying accomplishment in a tournament, winning his first tournament, the Hartford B with a score of 790 at the Worcester Rallies in 1937.
Call that one right, Craig. I wonder if BB's going to take it easy on the youngster.
Well, I don't know. BB never eases up on anyone.
There's a 10-year difference there. Pat has three grandsons and a granddaughter and a wife and a son. Wife Edith, son Joseph. He's retired, worked for the Budweiser and Schaefer distributor.
Dick, Pat's brother, Danny, is he also a left-hander?
No, he's a right-hander.
That's what I thought.
I think this is interesting. He served in the U.S. Army and was wounded in the Battle of the Bulge in 1944. Do you remember the Battle of the Bulge?
Not
did
I.
Did you ever hear of it?
Yes, I did.
Okay. In Europe.
All right, Pat's on board. Fifth frame with a mark. Beebe in the fourth frame with a mark. Fills his mark with six, leaves a difficult spare.
Beebe likes to hunt, too, up in Brattleboro, Vermont, in that area.
That went right between the eight and the five.
And like so many other people, he's a Yankees fan.
Yeah.
As you can see, right now, at this point in time, BB's up by 10 pins. Pat is, in fact, on a mark. Tell you, BB has a nice delivery.
Smooth.
Very smooth delivery.
Well, he's got 60 years of bowling. Is that about right? Yep. He started as a pin boy when he was 16. He's 76. His current average this year in the league at 138. Pat very fills nice with a nine.
Very nice ball.
The winner of this first match faces Bill Crudo in a two-game roll-off. Total pinfall for two games. Pat had a chance to come up even.
This tournament wins state doubles and New England doubles with his brother Dan. Won the New England team title.
There's a spare.
Guida's Dairy.
So BB with a one pin lead plus whatever he gets on the first ball here. And don't forget he has a two pin handicap. Two fill and a very difficult spare leaf.
Not too pleased with himself.
Well placed second ball.
It's marvelous to be able to bowl at the age of 76. I'll be happy if I can lift the ball at that age.
It is one advantage, though, to watching the seniors, especially BB and Pat, who have been active, bowling tournaments over the years. They show you something that's been lost in this game today. They've been brought up to hit the object pin at all times, to hit certain spares in a certain place at all times. Where today, the younger kids that are coming up, they're taught to throw as hard as they can.
Smash ball.
Right. Tremendous difference has come about in the game.
When they had wood without the hard rubber sidewalls, you could finesse to get your scores. Now they can smash a ball head on and have it bounce all over the pin, all over the place. Pick up a lot more wood.
Form still counts, though.
It certainly does.
And he gets his tap.
Let's take another look at it. Here's the slow motion coming up.
It's right where he's supposed to. Mm-hmm. That's basically what I was referring to. He had a definite purpose in mind when he threw that ball. It looks like Pat's warming up.
Pat's got a chance to surge ahead here. .83/7. Seven pin lead and a mark working in the eighth. 93+. .102. So he's working with a 16 pin lead minus the two pin handicap. 14 up. Got it working now. Three frames in a row.
Pat, like his brother Danny, both very, very smooth bowlers.
They're both tall, but they're smooth.
Right.
Right.
Danny, I think, pushes the ball a little more. I think That's probably the biggest difference, other than the fact that Danny is right-handed.
I think the first time I ever saw Danny bowl was probably about 5-6 years ago, and I was amazed at how smoothly he did deliver the ball, effortless.
BB's coming right back.
He's a fighter.
BB came to this country in 1916 from Italy.
Beautiful. He knew what he was doing. As soon as he let
Here's
go.
A replay.
Now watch him give
perfectly
it
perfectly delivered ball.
That look, the fist. Right in there. One more and he's got Pat on the hook. 116 plus in the 10th.
BB Messina normally bowls at Perillo's Bowlodrome in Waterbury.
Two full. Looking to pick up three or four more.
His high sets are 528, 515, and 507.
Dick, you say he'll go to the right of the three pin?
I would say he would. He'd shoot to 3-6.
.123 plus the two pin handicap, .125.
Lost his balance, but got it.
He managed to stay behind the line.
Watch this.
There See he that? Goes, out of the picture. However.
So do the pins, go out of the picture. Fortunately, didn't get hurt.
So recovery. Pat comes back to face Bill Crudo in our second match. In reality, it'll be a 20-frame match. Total pinfall for two games.
Beautiful. We'll be right back in a moment and take a look at the final scores. Back we are now as Bill Crudo comes to the line.
Well, this is going to be the match of left-handers, Craig.
Just like the practice frame he had before, where he struck, it's right in there. Billy qualified with 130, 150, 150.
Oh.
And this is the baby of the crew, of course. He's only 63, so.
Bill lives in Stratford, was born in Bridgeport. He's an electrician, retired.
This is where I think Pat has an advantage in the early frames. He came off those four or five marks.
He's throwing the ball well right now. I know the last five or six frames of the last game, you know, he was right there. Looks like he's right there now.
What a psychological advantage to start off with a double.
Yeah. Well, I guess he had to. He's spotting four pins this game.
Bill tried the crossover this time. Gets the same.
Well, Bill seems to be a pretty smooth bowler himself. I've never seen Bill bowl before.
You're not alone, Dick.
Bill went to Warren Harding High School, Warren Harding in Bridgeport. Veteran of World War II in Korea.
A little bit of bad luck there.
He's a Navy veteran.
See that Bill started bowling at age 30, bowling 10 pins. And I would have guessed that from his delivery, because it is somewhat of a 10-pin delivery.
Well, 5 years ago, he had a heart bypass operation, and this 16-pound ball was a little bit too much for him, so he converted to duck pins. He loves it so much that he's come over and become a very good duck pin average. You know, average bowler, he's gone from 105 up to 125.
Pat's thrown the ball very well. Very well.
Keeps that up, we're going to have to call him Mr. Laparta. And as we all do.
Some of us more often than others.
Yeah, when you're that close to having excellent hits every time, you're that close to the rip in the middle, too. Four frames into the match, and Pat's got a 68. Billy Crudo, in reality, has 40 pins through three frames. He has a four-pin handicap.
Says four there. Ooh.
Bill Crudo has improved his average over the last 5 years from 105 to 125. Enjoys watching fellow seniors in handicap bowling duck pins.
He dropped that one, but he still has a nice spare leaf. A little bounce at the foul line. Twenty pins down, couldn't take advantage of that spare leaf.
Pat Lepardo bowls at the Arcade Lanes in Torrington.
First time Pat's missed a head pin in about 10 frames.
Well, he was so full on the head pin last time, he probably
made an adjustment.
Made that little adjustment for get back over to the pocket. Got a spare leave, though, and took advantage of it.
Certainly did.
So he's 78 plus in five frames. Still falling. He's happy. Could have been one. He's got five for a fill. And a difficult spare leave. It's easy to go 1-5 or else take out the clothesline, but to do both.
Well, he gave it a good shot.
Pat's a pin bowler with three-step delivery.
Pat's 91, six frames. Bill needs a mark. Being a left-handed bowler, this isn't quite as bad as if he were a right-handed bowler.
He has a high single game of 188, high three-game set of 446.
Bill bowls at the Barnum Lanes in Stratford.
Ooh, nice try.
Barnum Lanes is a great house for senior bowlers. They have leagues all week long. Bill Basta has a lot to do with the leagues at the Barnum.
Has a lot of hobbies beside bowling. Swimming, horseshoes, volleyball. On and on it goes.
Barnum Lanes in Stratford, where Bill bowls, is one of the upstairs, downstairs houses, one of the few remaining. The one that was here in Willimantic at Lucky Strike was upstairs, downstairs.
Nice cover, very nice cover.
Some of the other lanes you may practice your bowling at are Highway Lanes, Route 12 and Plainfield, Johnson's Lanes, Dixwell Avenue, Hamden, and Laurel Lanes, Main Street, Winston.
Just to pick up on what you said before, Craig, as far as Barnum and their senior league business, that seems to be an ever-growing business throughout the industry. I think more and more seniors are finding it easier to bowl duck pins than to bowl 10 pins. You know, not having to fight the weight of the ball and so forth.
Well, I think that, you know, the fact that our initial seniors tournament drew 280 some odd bowlers is a pretty fair indication of the interest in duck pin bowling by seniors.
It also shows that they still have some competitive spirit too.
You have quite a few senior leagues at T-Bowl also, right?
Oh yes, we do.
How come none of your seniors are in the finals?
I told him to lay back. Well, we had a few that came close to making it, but
I saw Mo Tyrone bowling with B.B. Messina in the qualifier. He's one of your seniors, T.C. Cook.
Maybe I can take some glory for Pat, because Pat on occasion has bowled at the T-Bowl in the men's majors.
His brother still does.
Yes, he does.
He lays that ball down real smoothly.
Well, Bill had an opportunity, had the mark working for him. He only had two fill and nine frames, so he didn't gain too much on Pat. In fact, he only gained one pin over those two frames. Threw what he considered to be a lousy ball, but he got spare leave.
Holiday Lanes in Manchester is another establishment that has quite active senior program.
Lucky Strike here also.
Yes.
Johnson's in Hamden.
Beautiful ball.
Here's another look at it.
Call me Mister. Perfect.
Okay, what was the last pin the ball took out, Craig?
Well, it should have taken out the five last, but it took out the 10, didn't it?
Seven.
There's the five. Near perfect.
That's about as perfect as you can get.
If you can keep throwing that one and leave the five every time, you'd wind up with a 190, right?
You certainly will. Well, Pat's maximum score right now is 151. See if he throws a strike here. He'll have to settle for 149.
Well, halfway through, 149. Bill has 12 frames to overtake Pat.
Nice ball. Nice ball.
Beautiful.
You could see that as soon as he let it go.
Let's watch it again. Slow motion.
Excellent follow through. Ball is driving right in there.
Since this is the 10th frame, Bill stays on lane 15. Gets a re-rack. Has an opportunity to bring this match quite a bit closer.
Bill has not had any tourney wins until now. Switched over the duck pins from 10 pins at the age of 58. After a serious heart bypass surgery. Okay, we'll be back in a moment. And we continue on with our bowling with the two gentlemen, Pat Lopardo and Bill Crudo. And Pat steps to the line.
Pat Lopardo with a 20-pin lead.
Ooh, tough break.
Delivered it right into the pocket where he wanted it. Left his 9-10. Takes the 9, needs a 10 pin for a 10 frame. Has it. Billy needs some marks.
Two left-handed bowlers.
So they both start with 10 frames.
Some of Pat's hobbies are fishing, traveling, bowling, and softball. Four of them.
You know, and Billy Crudo, in addition to his bowling leagues, he still swims at the YMCA in Stratford. He's in a horseshoe pitching league in Shelton, and he's still playing volleyball every other Friday down at Edsoni at the Polish Falcon Hall. He's a pretty busy boy.
Certainly is.
Okay, so scoring-wise so far in the first game, Pat Laparta had a 149. Billy Crudo had 125 plus 4 pins handicap. So a difference there of 20 pins. Now Billy picks up an additional 4 pins in the second game. So while he's has 20 through two frames, he in reality has 24. And Pat has 16.
I think, sum it up very briefly, so win this match, he has to beat Pat by 17, correct?
Well, all he needs is another 12 pins right now at this point. Because he has 8 pins lead here, and he was 20 down in the first, so he's picked up 8 out of the 20 in 2 frames with the handicap. Pat's leaving it open.
All right, through 3 frames, Pat now has 25. Bill Crudo's 20 through the second. 26.
As we get further into the match and it gets a little closer, make sure we're in tune with what we're saying.
Ooh, no luck at
all. Oh, I expected
that
one to go. So lucky strikes, not lucky today. Ten for the frame.
Gives Billy 29 through the 30 through the third. 4-pin advantage for this game.
Bill has 8 grandchildren, and his son, Bill, must be Bill Jr., is a bowler also.
Right down the line. He's got him.
There's a replay in slow-mo.
Looking for his first mark of this game.
And that ball never came up.
Oh.
holds the pin for the 10 frame, which gives him 36 through 4.
It's getting closer. Billy has a fill in the fourth frame plus his four pins, so it would behoove Pat to start marking. Good ball.
Right on it.
Now if Bill can get a decent fill, I remember in the first game he had that two fill in the seventh frame that hurt him.
Okay.
He's got a nine fill.
Got a little bit of roll there. He's definitely going to want to make this one.
He's only three pins down in the overall match. Three pins and holding. Thirteen pins different there, plus the four pin handicap, 17.
Bill has improved his average over the last 5 years from 105 to 125.
Okay, caught a break there, going off the side.
Sure did. Missed the head pin and picked up eight.
Now the key is to capitalize.
Put the pressure back on Pat.
Pin for a 10 frame.
77 through 6.
Kind of a barren game of marks at this point.
It's the second time Pat has left the 9-10 this game.
Last time he went for the 9 first.
I would venture to guess it'll do the same.
Trying to move it over to the right.
Ooh, very close. Right,
well,
now it's a one pin match.
Right now, with four frames remaining, it's a one pin difference overall. In Pat Lapardo's favor. The way Pat came out in the first game with a double strike, we didn't think Billy was going to be in it, but right now he's at a slight advantage.
Commercial music.
We'll continue on with our game after these messages. We'll return in a moment. Bill Crudo coming back to the line. Bill, who bowls out of Stratford at the Barnum Lanes against Pat Lapardo of the Arcade Lanes of Torrington, Connecticut.
Must go to the right of the six pin to make this.
The type of ball that Bill throws, this is going to be a very difficult shot.
He can do it.
I'm not saying he can't. I'm just saying it's difficult.
Usually if you go for the 10 pin and hit it light, you've got it.
Giving it a shot.
Ooh. Good try. Good try. Need a little bit more right, and either the six pin or the nine pin would have gone over. Well, he had an opportunity there to surge ahead, but didn't quite take advantage of it. 84 to 69 through 7. It's still a one-pin match. Okay, now Billy rips the center.
Nice try.
A spot bowler with 3.5 step delivery.
You can see his eyes going from the pins to the spot to the and back again. Mm-hmm. Pair of sevens didn't help in that situation. To a match of attrition here now. Going three frames with no one marking. This doesn't look like a very good spare opportunity.
Nice try.
Pat has a high game of 222, high sets of 530.
Covers for the 10 frame. Gives him 79 in the eighth.
Pat's up by 4 pins at this point.
Pat has a high league average of 134.
Still a match. Four pin lead overall after 18 frames for Pat LaParta.
Notice Pat checking out the score.
Pat's beautiful at a disadvantage ball because he can't tell from the score he's looking at.
Here's another look at it.
Billy throws a nice ball here, crosses over. It's tremendous wall action. That head pin, if you saw it, when it went to the left-hand wall, went back across the plate, and then came back again a second time.
Took out the seven.
Right.
Worked so well once, why not try it again?
There you go.
Watch that lonely pin.
Well, being a converted 10-pin bowler, I think it's not unusual that he would be throwing at the, you know, it appears like he's throwing at the arrows.
Tried.
Almost called it. You could hear him holler one more time when he threw that ball.
Pat started the first game with a double. Bill finishes with a double.
Finishes with a 140. Plus his four-pin handicap gives him 144.
Pat must double. Wait till next year. Eighth game, our champion, Bill Crudo.
Time to award our winners. Come on in here, Beebe. Congratulations.
Thanks. Away, Beebe.
Congratulations.
Hey,
thank you very much.
I've seen better days.
You've seen better days?
I'll tell you truthfully, I've been up since 5 o'clock. I'm groggy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for bowling with us.
Well, we'll be there trying all along.
Okay, thanks,
Beebe. I never give up.
Okay.
76.
Pat. Thank you, Craig.
Come on in here, Pat. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Nice bowling today.
My pleasure. Thank
you. Okay, good luck.
Did my best.
All right. And Bill.
Congratulations, Bill.
Oh, thank you.
You're the seniors champion for the state of Connecticut at the moment.
Okay, thank you.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much, everybody, for joining us. For Craig Self and Dick Bissett, Norm Peters here. We'll see you again next week with another Duck Pin Challenge. Bye-bye for now.